answers are ready. Second and one, handoff to the up back. He's into the secondary, still on feet. One man to beat, and he beats him. He's going to go all the way. Number 42, Chris Connor. Touchdown, Linganore. And it's just that quick. Lightning strikes twice.
Lightning does strike twice. And listen, Linganore had to get off to a fast start here to kind of control the game. They're using their speed against them. Linebacker ran right past the fullback on that play.
What we need?
Double wing set, right wing into motion. DeWeese fakes the pitch, it goes around right and throws him in the end zone. Touchdown, Kentuckian Cougars. Number 8 on the reception for the Cougars.
Well, the Cougars did a great job setting that play up, going left with Herman on the read option, and then the big read option around the right of the big game, working him down inside the 5-yard line, trying to man wide open in the end zone.
The Bears are threatening to score once again. Mason keeps it around the right-hand side. Follows his blockers all the way into the end zone. Touchdown.
Touchdown, Oakdale Bears once again.
Yeah, just some great downfield blocking. Great execution by this offense.
Yeah, we knew these Oakdale Bears were for real, but I am so impressed with what I've seen here.
Introducing a new, exciting Asian restaurant to our listeners. Asian Number One Restaurant, located on East Frederick Street in Walkersville, is number one in taste, number one in convenience, and number one in value. Asian Number One specializes in Chinese fusion cooking. Check out their delicious noodle soups or their great Thai dishes. Lunch or dinner, Asian Number One is open 7 days a week, 11 a.m. to 9:30 p.m. Eat in or take out, affordable, convenient, and innovative. Asian Number One, stop by today.
All right, welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to South Carroll High School, home of the Cavaliers, and we have got the most exciting game of the year for you, the 2A West Regional Championship. The Cavaliers are hosting the Walkersville Lions, and my name is Michael Betteridge. I'll be doing your play-by-play, joined here in the press box with color analyst George Puvel and our stats guy, Michael Donahue. I want to thank you for tuning in to this very important game. George, how's it look out there?
Well, it's a brisk evening here, isn't it, Mike? About 40 degrees and dropping, but the air is nice and still. The flag unfurled down there is at half-mast and out of respect for recent tragedies. But we've got a calm game tonight between these two powerhouse 2A West Regional Championship teams, with the number 2 seed South Carroll entertaining the number 4 seed Walkersville Lions. This should be a great matchup tonight.
No doubt about it. And we want to thank our sponsors of tonight's game, the Animal Care Clinic of Walkersville. Thank you, Dr. Macenas, for sponsoring tonight's game. Anytime Fitness, Asia Number One Restaurant, Brownie's Auto Care, David's Salon, Gettysburg Auto Auction, Mount Airy Mattress, Salon Allure, the historic Shamrock Restaurant, and finally, Walkersville Eye Care. Thanks for sponsoring tonight's 2A West title matchup between the South Carroll Cavaliers and the Walkersville Lions. And we are here in Carroll County bringing this game to you live in its entirety. George, you know, these teams are coming in here pretty evenly matched. South Carroll, the number 2 seed. Walkersville, the number 4. Walkersville riding high off a victory over number 1 seed Oakland Mills last week.
Yeah, and what a game that was. You know, these two teams have a couple of common opponents, Liberty and Key.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, both South Carroll and Walkersville had their way with both of them about equally. Walkersville with a combined offensive output of 97 points. South Carroll putting 77 up on the board and being stingy on defense, shutting out both Liberty and Key in their matchup, while Walkersville gave up just a combined 18 between these teams. So, you know, we're looking at very evenly matched teams, ranked 34th and 36th, respectively, in the state of Maryland.
Yeah.
In the 2A, as 2A. And it's probably going to be one of those games that comes down to ball control and turnovers.
Yeah, no doubt about it. And you know, defense wins playoff games, and both these teams have great defense. I mean, I was looking at the South Carroll stats earlier. But South Carroll's got an 8-game win streak, and their defense has 5 shutouts this season.
Yeah, that's an incredible statistic for this team, and just goes to show you how well-balanced of a program they are.
Yeah, over on the other side of the equation, the Walkersville Lions, they've only given up 5.6 games or points a game for the entire season, too. So we've got 2 really good defenses here.
Well, you know, both these defenses are going to be keying on the ball carriers here tonight. Baca for South Carroll has 17 TDs on the year and over 1,000 yards rushing, while Jamar Williams has 12 TDs and almost 500 yards, but he's got a 12-yard per carry average. So,
well, yeah, there's also the experience factor that I want to mention here, too, because Walkersville has 7 starters that are sophomores, and they haven't
young
been...
program.
Yeah, they haven't been in a playoff game since 2012. They haven't seen this level since 1992. They haven't advanced to a semi since 1992.
Well, at 9-2 on the season, Joe Paulus, the head coach here, has a lot to look forward to as he's got a young team thick in the playoffs here in the 2A West.
On the other side of the equation, however, the Cavaliers are the 2A regional champ, 2A West regional champs from last year.
Right.
So they've been here before.
Yeah, and they're at home. So, you know, even though Walkersville's just a half an hour down the road, and they've got quite a contingency of supporters across the field.
Yeah.
Their stands are full. This stadium is packed.
Yeah, it was hard getting in here. There's traffic still coming, and we see the cars streaming in. And, you know, we got some great pictures before the game we're going to be putting up there. This game will be archived in its entirety on YouTube for you. You just type in Walkersville Lions football or South Carroll Cavaliers football, and you'll find it in YouTube. And it'll be up and available tomorrow morning.
Well, the teams are taking the field, and Walkersville is set to receive as the Cavaliers are going to kick off. And I didn't catch the coin toss. We had kind of a group around the officials at the time, so I didn't quite see the call. And either way, whether they deferred or whether Walkersville won and elected to receive, South Carroll is going to be starting this game on defense.
And the ball is being teed up right now on the 40-yard line of this natural grass field. It's looking a little bleak out there. Kind of a bit of a brown spot right down the middle. It's a crown field, and we're ready. Cavaliers will kick off left to right on your radio dial, and here is the opening kickoff. A short, high, end-over-end kick, taken at the 28, after the 30, 35, still on his feet and dropped at the 36-yard line, where Walkersville will take over, led by Billy Gant, quarterback, sophomore quarterback, first and 10 from their own 36.
Well, you know, pretty much a straightforward short kick, caught right around the 30, as you said, 28-yard line, advanced at about 7 yards and was brought straight down. Walkersville now in their first offensive series of possession to start this game.
I formation behind Gant. He's got 2 receivers split out wide. Hands off to the deep back off right tack. A little bit of a seam there, and he runs it out for about a 4-yard gain all the way out to the 40-yard line.
4-yard gain right up the gut, and I'll tell you, they opened up a nice little seam for him. Great job by the linebacker to stop him, but he had a head of steam and picked up 4 yards very fast. So we'll see you know, whether that continues and this offensive line for the Lions can, you know, keep knocking South Carroll back.
Chad Gleason, the leading rusher on this team, the second leader rusher on this team, the up back. Wetzel, the deep back, takes another handoff, busts it through. Oh, it's a keeper. The quarterback keeps, man, he fooled me completely on that, George. That was a keeper on an option.
Steven Stutzlager.
Yeah, now we'll have to see what happened there. I'm not sure, but there was some confusion. It looks like the ball came loose. The referees are talking about it now, but yeah, on the play action pass rollout right, he had nobody downfield and had to tuck and try to get around that edge and was stopped back.
So it's a motion penalty against Walkersville, and the South Cavalier coaches wave it off.
Yeah, they waved it off legal on formation. The loss, and they'll take the loss of down. It'll be 3rd and 10, but the receiver who was in motion started, turned upfield before the snap of the ball, and that's where they were penalized.
Ah, okay. Well, I thought he handed off to the deep back in the I formation, but next thing I know, the quarterback's got it. So here we go at it again. It's going to bring up a
3rd and 9.
3rd and 8. Yeah, 3rd and 9. He's going to pass, looking out to his left, got a man in the flat, wide open, caught, right at the first down marker. He gets a spot. It's going to be close. They're probably going to have to measure this one. I believe he's a little bit shy, about a foot shy.
Yeah, he's going to be about it, maybe half a foot to a football shy, and it's going to bring up fourth down. They're not even going to call for a measurement. It's obvious enough because the ball's placed right at the 45-yard line, the nose of the ball right on the 45, and the yardage marker is clearly about a foot past that. So it's going to be fourth down and a foot to go. Walkersville going for it.
And they're going with a power eye formation now. Hand off to the deep back straight ahead, and he's got the first down yardage. He just sticks his nose in there and goes for it. And got the mark from the far side of the field, and it's a first down.
Yeah, it was a great stop by that defensive front, but not enough. He only had a half a foot to go, and he just put his head down and barreled forward.
And that's what we expect from this Walkersville Lion team today here, is just the straight-ahead power running. We've seen them a couple times this year, and that's their game. That's what they do.
Yeah, not known so much as a passing offense, but here we have two attempts.
Well, they mixed it. Yeah, they mixed it out a little bit. Okay, back to the I formation, two receivers split. Hand off to the deep back, straight ahead. A little bit of a crease there, good for 3 yards.
Same play they started the game off with. Similar results, about three on the carry with forward progress. Going to bring up second down and 7.
And that was Wetzel on the carry. So that'll move the ball all the way up to the 50-yard line where the nose of the ball is sitting right on the 40, call it the 45.
Yeah, right on the 50.
Yeah, it's a 45-yard line. It's hard to tell. Those markers are kind of... There's a handoff.
He's
into the secondary, still on his feet. First down yardage and more all the way down to the 29-yard line. Again, Wetzel gets the call, number one.
Wetzel just burst through that hole right up the middle. Beautiful hole it was.
And that was Littleton. Through. Check that. Sorry, Littleton on the carry.
Correction, Littleton. And plenty for a first down. Ball all the way down right at the 40-yard line now of the home field Cavaliers.
Fresh set of downs for the Lions. Two receivers split to the right. Hand off to the deep back straight ahead. Again, a little bit of room there, and he gets a couple.
Yeah, nice stop up front there, limiting it to about a 2-yard gain. It'll be 2nd and 8 now for the Lions. Lions threatening now. Ball inside the 30, about the 38-yard line.
No score. If you just joined us, we're in the first quarter of this 2A West regional championship game here at South Carroll High School. The Lions have the ball, and they break it out with a 2nd and 8 now in Cavalier territory on the 29. Handoff straight ahead to the upback. He's got a host of tacklers all over him. Not much there.
Well, Walkersville tries to go off tackle to the left-hand side that time and was stood up and stopped maybe a yard. They're going to place it on the 37-yard line now for the Lions. That much to go to get up on the board early and ahead of South Carroll. We'll see if they can get a conversion here on third down and long.
Well, this is their first real challenge of the game for them. Wing left, offset backfield. He rolls to his right, wants to pass.
Got a man open.
Got a man wide open. He hits him, and he's out of bounds. Let's see if it's a catch. It's ruled a catch on the far side of the field.
Great job by the receiver to find a soft spot out in the flats for and up for a first down. A little bit of a rainbow ball. Kept his eyes on it and managed to haul that ball in and tiptoe his way just short of going out of bounds to make it a legal catch. First down, Lions.
I think they've thrown more in the last couple plays than they have all year, George.
It seems like it. Ball in the 25.
Here we go. I formation, handoff to the deep back, off left tackle, running, still his feet driving. Host of tacklers bring him down. A lot of black and yellow around him that time.
Yeah, may have gotten 4 or 5. These Cavaliers are definitely trying to strip the ball out of the arms that time. As it was, you know, less of a tackle than it was, you know, kind of whirling each other around, grabbing for that football. But he went down after about 4, so it's going to be 2nd and 6.
Yeah, no gain on the carry. The ball on the 20-yard line. The Lions break the huddle. Gant brings him up to the line of scrimmage, looks over the defense, leans down under center. Hand off to the deep backs, patiently waiting for the hole to open, but there's nothing there. And he's slammed to the ground on a really hard late tackle there.
Well, he was kind of on top of a pile, and it could have been that his knee wasn't really touching yet, and the defender wanted to ensure that he had made contact and stopped the play. So no gain, third down, 7, we'll call it, for the Lions. And again, they run into the third long situation.
Yes. Well, let's see if they come up with a pass again, but uncharacteristic, as I mentioned, but it's been successful so far. Straight drop, going to roll to his right. He wants to pass, got some pressure. He pulls it down and scrambles, but he's going to lose yardage. And so they lose about 3 on that one.
Yeah, quarterback rolls to the right and almost immediately faces pressure. Wasn't able to keep his eyes downfield, so he tucked it and tried to scramble for it. Lost about 3. It's going to be 4th and 10 now for the Lions as this drive is stalled by the great defensive effort here of the South Carroll Cavaliers.
So they're going to attempt a field goal. The ball is going to be spotted.
Lions, number 35, Noah Sadler.
On the... way short. The kick is not going to be even close to getting there. About 10 yards short. The ball was spotted on the 31. So that would have been a heck of a field goal in high school right there.
Just didn't quite get his toe into it. Got under the ball, and it just kind of, you know, did a straight up and down. So he'll... maybe get another shot at redemption here later in the game. But so far, Walkersville comes out and shows they can move the ball, both running and passing, a well-balanced attack, and pick up significant yardage, threatening South Carroll here. Ball all the way down almost into their red zone before they were able to stop them. South Carroll now will have their first attempt at offense of this game. If you're just joining us, 6 minutes and a second left in this first period of action.
So they're in the gun, straight drop, looking to his right, wants to pass, got a man deep on a post, it's caught!
Now that was a beautiful, beautiful pass.
40-yard post pattern, and he hits him with double coverage.
They had over the top coverage and underneath a pretty tight, excellent defensive pass coverage, but that pass just was perfectly thrown over the top of the quarterback following him, and dropped right into the basket of the receiver before the safety over top could come in and do anything about it. Big gainer across the midfield. Ball placed at the 44-yard line of Walkersville.
Hand off to the lone back in the backfield. He spins and falls ahead for 3 on the carry. That'll move the ball right into Walkersville territory on the 41.
Out 3 yards up the gut on first down.
2nd and 7 for the Cavaliers.
That's going to be 2nd down and 7 to go for the Cavaliers here. Clock ticking at getting close to 5 minutes to go in this first period.
No score here so far. The Cavaliers break the huddle, come out. Pistol formation, wing left, 3 receivers split out. Long snap count. He hands off to the lone back, straight ahead. Got some running room.
He's
in the secondary. Oh, a shoestring tackle. Saves the touchdown at the 25-yard line.
Yeah, big hole up the middle. He just blew through it, and after about 6 yards, cuts to his left. No one there to catch him. Just got caught by a shoestring tackle to bring him down and save a score by the Walkersville linebacker, trying to get his number to bring the name of the player to you. We'll see if we can get that.
Here we go. Pistol formation. 2 receivers split out to the wide side. Hand off to the left back. He tries to bounce it outside. He's caught in the backfield and dragged down for a 2-yard loss.
Great job by that defense on the left-hand side to get through that line and stop him for a loss.
Number 33 for Walkersville slicing in from that inside linebacker position into the backfield.
Yeah, Jake Borowski, by the way, in the previous play, was a linebacker able to get his arm out there and just grab an ankle to prevent that touchdown run. So we're going to have 2nd down and about 11, long 11.
Receiver in motion across the formation, a handoff to him, he breaks a tackle and run out of bounds into the Walkersville bench after a 1-yard gain. A lot of running, about 30 yards of running, but only 1 yard of forward progress.
Handoff to Williams around the left-hand side, and that Walkersville corner just came shooting in, almost dropped him for about a yard, 5-yard loss. He was able to escape and get back to the line of scrimmage, 3rd and 10.
So Walkersville, South Carroll in the no huddle now, looking to the sidelines for the play to be signaled in. They have a huddle for the offensive line only, and now they break the huddle out to the line of scrimmage. Four receivers split wide. Shotgun formation. Wants to pass. Rolling to his right. Looking. He's going to look. He fires, and it's caught. What a beautiful catch on the 15-yard line by number 23. Check that, number 20 for South Carroll. And he made a high, leaping catch. Outstretched arms to bring that one in.
Yeah, nice job by the quarterback rolling right. Gets a first down on a rollout right and just hit that tight end, Brent McPherson, perfectly in stride. Brought him down for a first down immediately. First and 10, ball now placed at about the 15-yard line.
Right. So the quarterback is up under center now. He sends a left wing into motion across the formation. Handoff off right tackle, caught in the backfield and dropped. No loss on the play. I think he lost a half a yard, George.
Yeah, great job there getting through that time by Jarvis Kane, number 33. Christian Policelli.
Christian Policelli with the tackle. Short loss on the play. Brings up second and 11 for the Cavaliers.
So that's going to be a yard loss with the spot of the ball. We've got a... Okay, they're going to get back into action here. Looked like there was going to be a little bit of a conversation, but everybody's happy. Second and 11, shotgun formation for the Cavaliers. Four receivers split wide.
Fakes a handoff, quarterback keeper off left tackle. He runs on a host of white jerseys. Not much there, maybe a yard.
Wow, great defense there by Walkersville. Not to be fooled on that quarterback draw. Great play call, actually, in this situation, but Walkersville sniffed it out and shut it down for no gain. Third and 10 now. Ball on the 15-yard line. South Carroll marches down on a big 35-yard first play of the game. Pass down the left-hand sideline and just grounded pound down to the 15.
Quarterback brings him out of the huddle, and then he turns and starts talking to his left halfback in the shotgun formation. He's in the gun with four receivers split out. He's rolling to his left, wants to throw. He's going to hold up, pull up. He's got some pressure. He scrambles outside. He's right out of bounds, right at the marker. No gain on the play. That'll be fourth down coming, George.
Well, he actually turned the corner there right at the flag.
Yeah.
Stayed in bounds, picked up three. He's going to be fourth and 7 now. Ball is going to be at about the 13-yard line.
Here comes their field goal unit out on the field now. The spot will be on the 19-yard line. So we'll call it about a
30-yard kick.
26-yard kick. Oh, it's blocked! It's blocked by Walkersville. The ball squirted all the way out to the 50, and they've got it.
Wow.
Walkersville falls on it out on the 50-yard line. What an amazing play by the Lions as they block the field goal, but the ball just skyrockets back to the 50. That's a 30-yard block. The ball went all the way. It hit the defender's arm like its elbow, the hard part of his elbow, and it shot like a cannon backwards.
Bruce Hanga, number 11 for Walkersville, after the block punt, as it went rolling backward about 40 yards, raced. It was a foot race between him and a Cavalier, and he got to it, giving Walkersville the ball all the way down on the 45-yard line.
So we've got a runoff left tackle, but there's a yellow flag here on the near side.
Henry Cook and Tom Jeller.
The side judge throws it out of his pocket. Let's see what the call is. Looks like they waved the flag off. So it'll remain second and 7 now. The Lions have the ball, and they're on the 43-yard line of the Cavaliers. Around the right end, number 22's got some running room, first down yardage and more. Nice 10-yard run by number 22.
Tackled by Travis Hurst.
Jake Wetzel on the carry moves the chains. And both these teams have shown that they can move the football against the other defense, but stall when they get close to the goal line inside of a minute to go in this first quarter of action. And what a great start to the game.
Here we go. Walkersville, wing, double wing set. Hand off to the left wing, right wing around left side. He goes straight ahead. He's good for about 2 yards, maybe three on the forward progress.
Gleason with the carry.
Gleason with the carry.
Tackle by Jason Money.
They give him four.
All right, ball placed at the 26-yard line.
That's going to bring up second and six now for the Lions. 22 seconds to go in the first quarter. No score. Lions break the huddle out to the line of scrimmage. Gant brings them up. Walker slowly taking their time.
Inside of 10 seconds.
Play clock down to eight. Hand off to the deep back off right tackle. Straight ahead. Just power running. Good for about three.
Littleton on the carry. We're going to change ends of the fields as that's going to mark the end of this first quarter of action. Walkersville will have the ball. Third and about two to go at the Cavalier 22-yard line. Yeah, looks to be about the 22. So both these teams will regroup here and start the second quarter of action. We'll see how Walkersville does with this second series in close on the Cavaliers.
The Athletic Department and Football staff would like to thank you, the fans, for the support that you've given our athletic teams this season. We feel that we have a very successful athletic program here at South Carroll High School, and this is only possible when we receive the fine support that you, the fans, have given us. A big thank you to the South Carroll Athletic Boosters for continued outstanding support for our athletic teams. Your help in boosting school spirit is greatly appreciated. The Booster Club will have their next meeting on Tuesday, December 1st. The meeting will be held in the Media Center and begins at 7 o'clock.
Welcome to the New Century Ford. We spent the last few months remodeling to enhance your car buying experience. And we are thrilled to show you our brand new stress-free showroom, a more spacious and comfortable customer lounge, an engaging and user-friendly service center. We want to thank you for your patience with grand reopening savings like these. Discover Mount Airy.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen.
Henry Cook.
We just had a play go off there, and
Billy Gant, the quarterback, handed off to the right-hand side to Chad Gleason for a short gainer. Or actually, that was third and two. It's going to be fourth and one.
Yeah, they're in two-down territory down there because the ball's all the way down on the 22-yard line now in Cavaliers territory. So they shuttle the play with two players into the huddle, a break huddle, and the Lions come out to the line of scrimmage now. Two receivers split way out to the wide side of the field, I formation behind Gant. Now we've got a whistle and a timeout called by, they're not telling us who called it. Timeout, Walkersville. All right. Thank you. They didn't indicate that initially, so we had to kind of wait on that one, George.
Well, critical fourth down here, only about a foot to go to keep this drive alive.
Several medical issues, and they are expensive, and the family is in need of assistance. If you would like to help the Merrick family,
ball placed just outside of the 25,
Bank in Mount Airy,
just outside of the 22-yard line.
Or drop money in the buckets located in school. Any and all donations are.
Well, Walkersville is going to talk it over with Coach Follis.
So, what do you think they were doing? They're looking at what the defensive set for the Cavaliers was. Is that the purpose of bringing it out?
Well, you know, it could be that they had the play call that didn't match up to the defense
right.
They were showing. So
okay.
Either way you look at it, just out of precaution, given that they're this close on fourth down.
All right, they're in the power eye, Walkersville is. Gant leans down under center. He's ready, all bunched up tight. The Cavaliers straight ahead.
Ooh.
First down yardage, but he took a heck of a hit. He paid the price for that one, but he got it.
He got the first down, but boy, did he take a wallop. Chad Gleason on the carry.
Tackle on the play.
So first down, ball's going to be placed inside the 20 at about the 18-yard line.
First and 10 for the Lions as they break huddle. Gant turns and talks to Gleason in the backfield. Again, power eye formation. The Cavaliers bunch in tight. Hand off to the deep back off left tackle. Got a little bit of a crease, and he uses it, takes advantage of it to pour ahead for about 5 yards.
Ty Littleton, the big back for Walkersville, coming up with a slight limp as he goes off to the sideline after the carry. pickup of about three, maybe 3.5 yards. It'll be second down. We'll call it a long six, maybe a seven to go here to keep this drive going. Ball placed right at the 15.
Well, they got to get to just beyond the 10, like not even the 9. So, yeah, it's 6 yards. So second and six. The Lions come up I formation, wing left. Again, handoff to the deep back. He follows his blockers off left tackle. He breaks through in the secondary. Touchdown, Walkersville Lions, number 5, all the way in.
Chad Gleason on the carry with a great job, not letting himself be brought down. Just dropped that shoulder, bounced off the back, and sprinted off his left for a touchdown. And Walkersville opens up the first score of the game here at the 10-minute, 10-second mark left to go in this first half of action. 6-0. They'll try to kick the PAT. Extra point team is out on the field. The ball was sputtered on the 10-yard line. There's the snap, the set. The kick is up. Nice, high, long kick, and it is good. 7-0. The Lions have broken out on top with 10-10 to go here at the South Carroll Cavaliers Parker Field. We'll be right back after this commercial message.
If you own a business, you know that the workday doesn't begin and end with the hours posted on your door. Hi, this is Business Development Officer Clark Briggs, and at Frederick County Bank, we understand that too. That's why we make business banking easy and accessible, anytime, anywhere. From BuzzPoint's merchant reward and loyalty to online banking, remote deposit capture to business courier service, Frederick County Bank, Frederick's true community bank, is open for business anytime, anywhere. Contact me at 301-620-1400 and online at fcbmd.com. Member FDIC.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to South Carroll High School. The Walkersville Lions have just drove down the field on the strength of their power running to put one up on the board there, and they've taken the lead 7-0 here. And they're ready to kick off left to right. It's a flat line drive kick, takes a two-hopper down to the 8-yard line, out to the 5, 15, 20, 25, 30. He's got a seam, still on his feet, and he's driven out of bounds into the Cavaliers bench at the 45-yard line.
To the 45-yard line, where the Cavaliers will take over first and 10.
Christian Policelli saved what might have been a touchdown as he fended off his blocker and was able to get a sufficient angle at the 45-yard line.
Got a holding call. That's coming back.
Okay, well,
That 35-yard return is going to be negated on a holding call, and you hate to see that.
Well, we'll see. That's a spot of the foul, kind of a penalty.
Yeah. So the spot of the foul is a 32, so it's going to be taken back to the 22-yard line where the Cavaliers will take over first and 10. So they're in their own territory on the 22 now. Cavaliers in their home. Black uniforms, black helmets, blue, with gold lettering.
Blue and gold.
Fish. Blue? Is that
what?
Blue?
Wait a minute.
It's black to me.
Black and gold. You're right.
All right. I know I'm getting colorblind in my old age.
Yeah. Well, how about those Color Rush uniforms on Thursday nights?
Yeah. Oh, my goodness.
Jeez.
Yeah. Here we go. Three receivers split out, pistol formation. The slot goes into motion across, handoff to the lone back. Got a little bit of room there, but it shuts down quickly after a 2-yard gain.
Steve Baca with the carry.
Steve Baca, the big back leading rusher.
Yeah. 220 pounds of him.
Yeah, stopped for a yard gain.
They got some big boys out there. That plumber kid, number 76, the one that's signed a letter of intent to Maryland, I think he goes to what, 320?
Let's see, that's Brian Plummer, I believe.
Yeah, that's him.
Yeah, he's 6'7", 320.
Yeah, 6'7", 320, that is a load.
Is a high school senior.
That's a beast. All right, shotgun formation. Across the gun goes the motion man, looking for a pass. Straight drop, got some pressure. He pulls it down and scrambles out to his right, and he's caught and dropped for a 3-yard loss. Great defensive effort by the Lions.
You know, great effort to give some sufficient protection by the Cavalier offensive line, but an equally great job in coverage by Walkersville. caused the quarterback to finally have to step up and try to scramble for it and was dropped for a yard loss. It would be 3rd and 11. That's what we call a coverage sack, George.
Yeah.
So we've got a little discussion for the Cavaliers going out on the field as they bring the offense. Line-only huddle. Three receivers, four split out wide. Balanced line, shotgun formation. Low snap, he picks it up off the turf. He's got some pressure, he's going to take the sack. Well, wham, he is slammed. Uh-oh, and there's a flag comes out after the hit.
That's going to be taunting. It's going to give the Cavaliers a first down.
Number 42 on the tackle.
Tackled by Jared Spriggs,
wide
play.
Just an excellent blitz up the middle. He had a man wide open down the field, streaking, had probably four or five steps on the safety. Plenty of range for that quarterback's arm, but, man, he was just hit and dropped. And, unfortunately, he was so excited about it that he kind of got in his face a little bit. It's going to cost him.
Well, it's not enough. It's going to make it third and short, maybe third and two.
Okay,
well, not enough for the first down.
Well, I guess they're taking into account
the
loss.
Fourth down. They lose the down. It's fourth down. Here comes the punting unit on the field. So,
yeah,
I don't understand that one.
I don't either. I mean, why do they lose the down?
I don't know.
All right.
Ah, okay, so it was because it was after the play. Punting unit is ready. There's a nice snap, kick from the 20-yard line as an end-over-end wobbler. It's going to take fair catch at the 43, where the Lions will take over now with a 7-point lead, first and 10 from their own 43.
Lions will take over first and 10 from their own 43-yard line.
Excellent play by this Walkersville Lions defense to shut that drive down. Holding the big back to just a yard, getting that blitz up the middle, and preventing the quarterback from even letting go of the ball to a wide open receiver. Would have been a huge, probably would have been a touchdown had he let it fly, but just a great job by Walkersville.
Gant has two receivers split out wide, and he's got an I formation behind him. He takes his time, leans down under center now. Hand off to the deep back off left tackle. A little bit of a crease, maybe a couple. Not much there this time.
Becca held so far in this game to 16 yards, Mike, on four carries.
Well, we talked about that before the game, that the key to stopping this South Carroll team was going to be to key on Becca. That's how South Hagerstown got the only win against them this year.
Yeah, the only loss for the Cavaliers in only by a point, too, against that excellent game plan by South Hagerstown.
Double wing set, handoff to the right wing around left end. He's got first down yardage and more. Great play. They run the double wing, the Delaware special, and they run that C back around the left end on the jet sweep.
It's going to depend on the spot of the ball to see whether he got enough for a first.
That's short. Yeah. I got a little optimistic there on the far side.
Yeah, well, it's going to be about a foot. You weren't off by much.
Call it third and inches. Yeah, it's about a foot. I'm looking in the binoculars over there. Ball spotted inside Cavaliers territory. We'll call it the 48-yard line. Gant stands up, leans back down under center, and now they stand up and call timeout. I think he'd run out. He was down to 3 seconds on the play clock, and they needed to get that one called to timeout. So we've got timeout here on the field. That'll give us an opportunity to step aside and let you learn about our great sponsors here for this game. Thank you so much for tuning in. This is AM 1450, your source for the best high school sports in the region.
If you were at the Gettysburg Auto Auction last Thursday, you watched over 420 vehicles go through the auction doors. Gettysburg Auto Auction continues to grow in both registered vehicles and numbers sold. Gettysburg Auto Auction is located on Route 15 at the Maryland-Pennsylvania Line Steinware Exit. For directions and a sampling of upcoming vehicles, visit our website, gettyauto.com. Gettysburg Auto Auction.
All right, welcome back to South Carroll High School over here on Liberty Road, just outside of Wingate, Maryland, where the Cavaliers have it all stacked in tight to try to prevent this first down yardage
Walkersville straight ahead, power rush. Gets the good spot and moves the chains.
Ball handed off to Gleason up the gut, following his lead blockers. Enough for that first down. Ball's going to be in Cavalier territory, spotted right at the 45-yard line. Walkersville, if you're just joining us, scored on their second possession and lead 7-0 in this contest with about 6.5 minutes to go in this first half of action in the 2A West Regional.
Hand off to Littleton, straight ahead, power running, only a one or two at the most. They drive him back and drop him in the backfield, but his forward progress is going to give him about, let's call it a yard on the carry.
Nice, stout, up front defense by the Cavaliers to stop the big back, Ty Littleton. And he may have gotten about 6 inches on that. It's going to be, we're going to call it second and almost 10.
Wing left, they move, there's going to be a flag. All the way out, 9-yard gain on the run, no flag. There was some movement on the line. The coaches here on the near side are going nuts for the Cavaliers because we saw the left end jump, George, but they didn't catch it.
Oh, geez, that was...
You saw it?
Plain and clear. Yeah, I was waiting on that hanky.
So that's going to make it 3rd and 2 now with the ball spotted on the 37-yard line in Cavaliers territory. Walkersville quickly out to the line of scrimmage. Gant brings them in. I formation, wing right. Hand off to the deep back, straight ahead. He will not get it. He was denied, met right at the line of scrimmage and hit hard and driven backwards.
Yeah, I mean, it was kind of an obvious play call. I think, that was just, hey, we're going to bring Gleason.
And here we come.
In the short yardage situation, and you're going to have to stop him. And stop him they did. This is two-down territory. Walkersville might have been able to afford a little bit more creative play than that, but 4th down and 2.
Well, they're going with the same formation. They shuttle the play in. Gant brings him up. He turns and pitches to the deep back. Half back, option play, and he overthrows him wide open. And little Gleason grabs his helmet and says, oh, no, it had 6 points all over it.
That would have been the perfect 3rd down and short call right there.
That's a turnover right now. But he overthrew him by about a yard. He tried to one-hand it
just out of the outstretched left arm of number 22 for Walkersville, Jake Wetzel.
So that drive fizzles, and they turn it over on downs to the Cavaliers. And let's see if the Cavaliers, with 4:40 to go in the half, can get anything on track here. They spread the offense, pistol formation. Hand off to the lone back. He goes straight ahead. Got some running room out to the about a 6-yard gain there.
It's like now they didn't call, look like he had a little hand on the face mask there, but it went unnoticed by the officials. Nice gainer, 6 yard on 1st down. 2nd and 4 to go here. Ball across the 40 at about the 43.5-yard line.
They break the huddle out to the line of scrimmage now. Long snap count. Quick out to the right, and it's in the ground. That was a dangerous pass. That had pick six all over it.
Yeah, the ball was low and outside of the slot back's ability to make an adjustment on it and catch it. And good thing it was, because the Walkersville Lion defender would have jumped that route probably and had himself a pick six. So 3rd again and about 4.
3rd and 4 for Lynn. As he brings them out, this time 4 receivers, 2 slots, 2 wideouts. Lone back in the backfield on his right hip pocket, straight drop, wants to pass. Got a man on a quick out, and he catches it, and he's caught and dropped down immediately, but not until he gets first down yardage, and they'll move the chains with that one all the way down to the 49-yard line in Lions territory.
Yeah, just a quick button hook by the slot back. Saw the yardage marker he needed, got a yard pass, and turned around and came back, got the ball, and up for a 1st down. Ball is just across midfield, spotted about the 49.5-yard line of Walkersville. The Cavaliers looking to tie this game up before halftime, 3:48 left.
4 receivers split out wide, again with the gun. Hand off to the lone back around right end. He breaks 1 tackle. tackle, drives ahead, and he's picked up and slammed to the ground. The crowd wants a flag, but it was tit for tat, since that's exactly what they did to one of the Walkersville players a little while ago in the first quarter.
Well, they're going to give him 3 yards on the carry. I think he slipped and his knee went down, but he got back up and kept running, and that's when he was brought down with force. But the referees saw the knee touch, so they brought him back
with personal affection. Three receivers split wide. Lynn turns and talks to his back, Baca. Pistol formation, two backs. He hands off to the right back. He pops it around left in a beautiful shoestring tackle by number six. He got one little finger. He brought that running back down, and that was going for a sizable game.
Tyler Gleason came up from his linebacker position, shot across the line, and just had enough reach in that arm for what otherwise might have been a decent gainer around the left-hand side.
It was going because he had the edge.
No gain on the play. Third down and seven for the Cavaliers.
Third and seven. They've got a wing left. They send the wing into motion. They turn around and roll to their right. They want a pass. Got a man caught. First down. 10-yard gain.
Very well executed pass play. Play action pass, roll to the right. Had a crossing route receiver freed up on another crossing lane, almost like a pick, but we don't like to call it that. Out in the flats, enough for a first down.
So Lane brings him up to the line of scrimmage now. Again, same formation. Operating from the gun throughout this game. He's ready. He takes a snap, rolling to his left. He wants to pass. Got a man, throws it deep. It's going to be up in the air and no good as the receiver tries to run underneath the floater, but it falls too far out of his outstretched hands.
Yeah, ball dropped right at about the 1 yard line next to the cone. Receiver made a great adjustment on the ball and almost got to it, but
he did.
Couldn't
he made an amazing adjustment. I didn't think it was within 5 yards of him, and all of a sudden, he got a fingertip on it.
At number eight, Jamar Williams, wide receiver we're talking about, 5'8", 170-pound speedster.
Lynn brings him out to the line of scrimmage now. He's got three receivers to the wide side, one to the narrow. Long count, straight drop, wants to pass, got some pressure. He's got a middle screen, it's good. He's on his feet down to the 10, the 15, and driven out of bounds. Beautiful call by the offensive coordinator on that play. A middle screen, they released in the middle, and the Walkersville Lions bit, and they came strong and opened up that inside.
Steve back on the reception. Able to get the ball inside the 20, down to about the 16. Let's see where they spot this ball. A little bit of confusion there. Okay, it's placed right on the 15. Cavaliers come up to the line with a fresh set of downs. 15 yards to go.
Lynn's ready. Barks out the snap count. Hands off to the back off left tackle. He's caught at the line of scrimmage and dropped for no gain.
Nothing there. Once again, Tyler Gleason came up and made the stop. Right at the line of scrimmage.
So Walkersville managing to shut down an inside run.
Looks like we've got a penalty.
Chop block,
I'm hearing.
So we've got a chop block now. They're going to march it off against the Cavaliers. That could be a very costly penalty for them, George.
Yeah, that's going to take them outside of even field goal range.
Right.
They haven't stepped it off yet. We'll see where it gets spotted.
Well, if you just joined us, Walkersville drove it down the field and on a 20-yard scamper scored to take the lead 7-0 here with a minute 42 to go in this first half. And they're marking that one off.
That's a big penalty.
Huge.
Well, are you sure he didn't go too far with that?
I don't know, man. I mean, it looks like
a 10.
It's first
20,
and 30.
It's like a 25. Looks like a 25-yard pass.
Yeah, I don't understand. All right. Well, the Cavaliers have the play signaled from the sideline. They're all the way back.
All right.
On their own 35-yard line, first and 10. Lynn taking his time, takes it, straight drop, wants the pass, got some pressure, scrambles out to the left, he pulls it down, he wants to run it, spins, breaks one tackle, and then he's caught from behind and dropped by number 11. Good defensive pursuit on the backside by the Lions.
Well, good job by the quarterback to get a positive gainer out of that. Ball's going to be spotted at the 31. He's going to get a few of them back, but still, it's going to be second down, and we're over 20 yards.
A minute 18 to go as DeLynn brings him out. Straight drop, wants to pass, looking for the slant, throws it up deep into the end zone, up in the air, jump ball, and it comes down, broken up by the defensive back for the Lions.
Patrick Kelly went up for the catch and didn't come down with it. Hit him right in the chest as he made a well-timed leap. However, he had a lion on his back, so to speak, figuratively or literally, Mike.
He had a back on his back.
Yeah.
A backer on his back. Let's call it what? Third and 20?
Yeah.
Third and 20.
He had his tight end wide open on a seam route there. Just didn't pick him up. Could have hit him right at about the 10-yard line.
Ball's on the 31. Lynn, straight drop, looking to his right, now looks left to his check. He's hit just as soon as he releases it. He throws it up in the air, and it's incomplete. Broken up by number 4, the defensive back for the Lions.
Well, you're in two-down territory here, outside of field goal position. Be a 47-yarder from this point, 48-yarder maybe. So that's going to bring up fourth down.
Yeah. Fourth and 30. 20, excuse me, fourth and 20 from the 30. So they're going to go for it. I mean, of course they're going to go for it. You're down by 7. You're getting ready to go in the dressing room with 58 seconds on the clock. They huddle up the line of scrimmage. The offensive line has a snap count. Pistol formation, 4 receivers out in the formation. Now the referee calls timeout. Let's see who called that one.
That was the Cavaliers.
Cavaliers timeout on the field, so we'll step aside for our next break as they sort this one out. Very important play for these South Carroll Cavaliers right now. Fourth and 20. We'll be right back.
We're lost.
No, we're not.
Yes, we are.
No, we're not. It's just around the corner.
We have the choice to either run our own lives or give that control to God.
Why don't we ask for directions?
I can do this on my own.
God knows the future, and He loves us. Until we give Him control of our lives, we're lost.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to South Carroll High School. We're bringing you the 2A West regional title game here between the South Carroll Cavaliers and the Walkersville Lions. Walkersville on top, 7-0, with 58 seconds to go in the half. And the Cavaliers have what has been up until now the biggest play of the game for them. They have a 4th and 20 from their own 30. Lynn. Long count. Here comes a blitz up the middle. Some holding. Oh, and he slams in the quarterback. Wide open.
Touchdown.
Touchdown.
Well,
and the quarterback's on the ground. I don't see it. I got a flag. We got a flag.
That's going to come back on a hold.
Coming all back on a hold. Wow. You hate to see that happen. But that blitzing line, that blitzing backer up the middle got held, didn't he?
He did, but, you know, he still is the one who hit the quarterback, and he's in some obvious pain, A.J. Lynn.
Lynn is hurt.
And
he's been walking around now, so he's okay.
Yeah. Well, had he not been held, I don't know if he would have got up.
Yeah.
I mean, that was...
I see your point. Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Holding on South Carroll.
You know... Just a great defensive move to get past that tackle.
Did you see who that was that made
full speed? Now
the sack. Number 2?
Yeah, it was Pat Sachet.
Okay.
Outside linebacker, senior, 6 foot, 190 pounder, and he brought
all
that
all
to bear.
Well, the ball is spotted all the way back now on the 34-yard line, and that's going to be 4th and 30.
And we're going to get another timeout here by...
Yeah, they're going to call timeout.
Yeah, we're going to see. We've got 53 seconds left in this first half, and they're going to decide whether to punt it or go for it.
All right, that'll give us a chance to take another break. Only 53 seconds on the clock. Don't go anywhere. This is a great game. We're having a blast.
Everybody knows that high school sports generate suspense, excitement, and drama.
They also generate higher grade point averages, stronger work habits, and greater self-esteem.
Everybody knows that high school sports give us more value for our entertainment dollar.
They also give us leaders committed to strengthening communities right here in Maryland. The true value of playing sports in school can't be measured in wins and losses or dollars and cents. Studies show that participation in sports, along with other extracurricular activities, is one of the best ways to teach leadership, cooperation, accountability, and other invaluable life skills. Don't just stand on the sidelines. Encourage the young people you know to get in the game. When you do, you will be helping them get ahead in life. High school sports, a winning part of a complete education. This message presented by the Maryland Public Secondary Schools Athletic Association and the Maryland State Athletic Directors Association.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. South Carroll has decided during that timeout to punt it away, and the kicker kicks a line drive flat kick, and it squibs all the way down to the three-yard line where it's downed by the punting team. So Walkersville will take over with 41 seconds on the clock, a seven-point lead, and they will have it first and 10 with their backs into the end zone.
Yeah, nothing fancy here. Just get into halftime with your seven-point lead. I'm sure Gleason will probably take a couple up the gut, and that's going to be it.
Yeah, a couple of quarterback sneaks. That ought to do it. Here we go.
Yeah, 41 seconds here.
Straight ahead, just like I said, quarterback keeper at the middle, a sneak. And he gets a couple. The clock starts running down to 30 seconds to go now.
Bill, again, not going to take any chances even on a handoff. Keeps it himself. 25 seconds left here now. And the Lions will just be able to take a knee. They may not even have to...
No, there's 18 on the shot clock.
Shot clock.
I was watching a basketball game the other night.
Yeah, they're ahead of it. The game clock's...
Right, ahead of the
play
clock.
A couple seconds ahead.
They could just
game.
Let it run out now. Yeah. Well, that's it, ladies and gentlemen. That's the end of the half. The Walkersville Lions will take a 7-0 lead into the locker room. The South Carroll Cavaliers will have a chance to regroup and figure this one out. We'll take a quick break, and when we come back, we'll give you our first half stats and much, much more. We'll get you started, and we want to thank you for tuning in. We'll be right back after this break.
Mount Airy Mattress is not about gimmicks. It's about sleep. They believe they can help you learn how to sleep better. Their family is dedicated to providing you superior service at the best price. That's why they'll donate a portion of your mattress purchase to your favorite charity. Shop at a place that truly cares about you and your sleep. Mount Airy Mattress. See for yourself. Stop by today, located on East Ridgeville Boulevard, just off Route 27 in Mount Airy, or call at 301-829-8855. Mount Airy Mattress, your local sleep specialist. Mount Airy Mattress is a proud supporter of Linganore football.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to South Carroll High School. Home of the Cavaliers, where we have a record crowd here tonight. It's just a great night for football. A chill finally in the air. It feels like football. And Walkersville Lions have taken a 7-0 lead here basically on the power running of that team and great defense. I think you can't say enough about the Walkersville defense in that first half, George.
There I am, Mike.
Yeah.
Couldn't find the go button.
Turn that mic on.
Yeah, right? There you go. You're absolutely correct. And, really a very evenly played first half.
Right.
Both teams moving the ball, but stalling down in the red zone. Walkersville, with a run by Gleason, able to break one open and account for the only score in this contest so far. One missed field goal was the only other attempt at a score. Let's take a look here at some of the numbers. South Carroll quarterback, A.J. Lynn, is 5-for-9 for 73 yards. Half of that, accounting on the first play of the game, is he just threw a beautiful
That was a
35-yarder down the left-hand side to move the ball across midfield, and it looked like the Cavaliers were on a roll, but Walkersville stood them up and stopped them. And they returned the favor, and back and forth it went on the second possession. Walkersville, first possession that carried over into the second quarter, Walkersville was able to score. Big back number 34 for South Carroll is Steve Baca. That's right. I couldn't think of his
boy,
first
name.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Baca's a 6'2", 210-pounder, and 1,000 yards ball carry this year.
Almost 1,100.
Yeah. Well, he had 25 yards on 8 carries.
Well, he's got over 1,100 now then.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you know, the point here is that Walkersville's holding him to about a 3-yard per carry or per game, you know, carry.
Yeah. And what's his average, do you know?
Good bit more than that. Not sure I have that handy, but, you know, still, that's a great defensive job against their feature back.
11.9 yards to carry is his average on the season.
Okay, well, there you go. Walkersville High School. Let's see, we've got quarterback Billy Gantz, 2-for-2 for 20 yards.
Yeah, go figure on that one.
And that was early in the game.
Yeah. I mean, he threw one pass last week, and it was incomplete.
Yeah,
during the whole game.
Well, Gleason's been carrying the load. You know, their back, Chad Gleason, the junior, 5'8", 170 pounders, got the TD in the game. He's averaging over 5 yards a carry.
Ouch, yeah.
He's got 56 yards.
Mm-hmm.
And let's see, Littleton's carried the ball for 25 yards. He's got about a 3.5-yard average in this first half. So Walkersville's running game is producing a little bit more, and the Cavaliers' passing game's kept a minute.
Yeah.
So we'll see what adjustments are made at halftime, but this is an excellently played regional championship opener here in the 2A West.
Yeah, that South Carroll offense is dangerous, George. I mean, they can break it, but the difference in that first half has been the defense's ability to get in the quarterback's face and to shut down the passing lanes.
So. Yeah, and they have done an excellent job at coverage, too, in the spread offense.
All right, we'll step aside for our halftime mix now, give you a little music, give you a chance to run out to the refrigerator and get something cold to drink. We'll be right back.
Serving our community for over 50 years with quality service at a fair price, Brownies Auto Repair employs only ASE-certified technicians. Brownies is one of only 33 shops in the state of Maryland designated as an ASE Blue Seal of Excellence repair facility. They want to help you maintain your vehicle in a manner that keeps it trouble-free and fun to drive. Stop by today. That's Brownies Auto Repair, located on Frederick Street in Walkersville, a proud sponsor of Walkersville High School Athletics.
You deserve the best. Let expert stylists give you the look you've always wanted. David's Salon is a full-service salon offering great haircuts, coloring, highlighting, and perms. David's Salon is located in the Walkers Village Shopping Center in Walkersville. New clients receive 20% off their first visit. Ask about our Tuesday and Thursday specials. Call us to schedule your appointment. 301-845-4050. David's Salon, our passion is your happiness. Our success is you looking your best.
Alright. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to South Carroll High School. We are about ready for the opening kickoff of the second half here. If you've just joined us, the Walkersville Lions, on the strength of their power running, took a 7-0 lead here midway through the first half. South Carroll threatened several times, but the Walkersville defense shut her down and kept them off the scoreboard here throughout that first half. So we've got a 7-0 ball game here with Walkersville on top. There's going to be another 24 minutes to play here. We're coming up on the third quarter, and the difference will decide who will move on to the Maryland State MPSSAA semifinals next Friday evening. But right now, we've got the 2A West regional title game to be settled here at South Carroll.
Yeah. Well, you know, very evenly played first half. I mean, really, it comes down to a holding call that took that touchdown away from the Cavaliers.
That's a good observation, George, because they were definitely looking. They were way down there. They had, what, a 3rd and 6? Oh, just a beautiful pass into the end zone as he got drilled. Yeah, he never saw the catch. He was looking at the sky when that ball was caught.
Yeah. But, you know, the defender on the blitz that hit him actually was held just prior to that. And the official caught that, negated that touchdown, or we'd have an even score coming into this second half. But, you know, evenly played. Both these teams really are doing a great job at moving the ball, converting on third down. But, you know, likewise, they're both getting stalled once they get down close. So, you know, you've got the black and gold of South Carroll against the blue and gold of Walkersville. And if it wasn't for the fact that Walkersville was in their all-white uniforms, the way these teams are playing, it'd be hard to distinguish them with my, you know, with my colorblind eyes. But, I really, just a very, very well-played game up to this point. Look for more of that in the second half as we get ready to start. The Cavaliers are going to receive, having kicked off to start this game. Up left, right on your radio dial, the ball will be spotted on the 40-yard line where the kicker is teeing it up as we speak. So I doubt if the coach has, you know, made any great adjustments during halftime. They just basically said, keep playing hard, boys, and we'll get it. So here we go. A flat kick taken right at the 25, out to the 30. Cuts to his left, goes out wide, back to the 30, out to the 35, still on his feet. And whoa, slam from behind by number three and down at the 40-yard line. What a blindside hit. From the backside.
Hello, that was Aaron Janke. I'd like to introduce myself. Great hit by the sophomore to bring him down. Ball's going to be spotted right at the 40-yard line.
That
returner said, did anybody get the number of that truck?
Wow.
Yeah. That 20-yard return, nonetheless, is going to give the Cavaliers great field position to start the second half. Down by a score, 7-0.
Power right line, pistol formation. They send the slot in motion, hand off to the lone back, and he's met right at the line of scrimmage, and he's going to lose a half a yard.
Yeah, they might give him his fall forward and put it right back at the original line of scrimmage. Now he lost a half a yard. You're right.
So we'll call that no gain on the carry. As they ran, they took the slot on the left side and ran him in motion, faked the handoff to him, and then he gave it to the pistol back. Now he's got a true pistol formation, two halfbacks on both pocket. He hands off to the left back off right tackle, straight ahead running, caught at the line of scrimmage and dragged down. He falls forward for 2 yards.
Baca
on the carry. Baca was hit high and was able to keep driving his feet to pick up two after being met at the line of scrimmage. It's going to bring up third down and 8.
I love saying that, Baca. You know what Baca means in Spanish?
Party?
Cow.
Oh.
Very glamorous. You thought it was going to come out with some.
I was thinking of the Bacchanal. I guess that's Greek or something. I don't know.
Yeah, okay.
Anyway,
here we go.
Third and 8.
Trips right, looking to his right. He wants to throw deep. He's got some time. He takes a sack. Oh, he breaks a tackle and back to the line of scrimmage. Great scramble. No, the original line of scrimmage, so he lost two.
Walkersville with that inside blitz is able to penetrate that line and get to that quarterback. A.J. Lynn doesn't have more than, you know, maybe two seconds to find his receiver and get it out of his hand. And that secondary of Walkersville is providing enough coverage for that blitz to be effective.
So the Cavaliers go 3 and out, and the momentum is still on the side of Walkersville. There's a punt. Nice spiral kick taken at the 31, bounces and rolls out of bounds at the 34. It took a Walkersville bounce on that when they spotted it at the 34.
No,
that was dangerous. That almost hit the receiver in the chest.
Well, the receiver came right up to the ball, and then at the last second just didn't put his arms out to catch it.
Yeah.
And almost got hit by the ball.
I thought he was going to fair catch it.
I mean, there was nobody around him. No reason not to catch it. Well, anyway, Walkersville will take over.
at their 35-yard line, 34-yard line, let's call it. Two receivers split out wide, one in the slot, I formation behind Gant. He hands off to the deep back off left tackle, follows his blockers patiently, still on his feet, driving, churning, looking for that second effort. The ball pops out, but they say forward progress had stopped and the whistle blew, and they're going to give him 8 yards on the carry.
Again, you know, that defense tackling up high, you got to get down in that lower midsection to stop those legs, and Walkersville back just too strong, drove him back for a good 8 yards. It'll be second and a short two.
Ball's on the 43-yard line now in Walkersville territory. Same formation for the Lions. They flip it to the near side here. Handoff off right tackle, straight ahead, running, power running. Not much there, maybe a yard. We're going to have third and short coming.
Nice job on the right-hand side there by
Ty Littleton with the carry.
Carry by Ty Littleton.
Tackled by a host of Cavaliers.
But a host of Cavaliers brought him down, but they moved the chains, giving the first down. He just got the nose of the ball over that first down marker. Yeah, big Brian Plummer met him and stopped him, but not before he got that first down.
So the ball spotted on the 45-yard line, still in Lions territory. Gant brings him out. Wants to pass, rolling out to his left. Got some pressure from the backside. Throws it a little long, and it's incomplete.
Yeah, it was a nice attempt at a pass. He didn't have a great placement of his feet with that pressure on him. Just tried to lay it out there, but just a little bit too long, fell incomplete.
You know, I got a pet peeve about rolling a right-handed quarterback to his left and throwing on the run. I mean, he can't stop and set and square his shoulders and throw the ball in there. He's running to his left, trying to throw right-handed.
Got to have that backside protection to allow him the time to square up.
Gant's ready. First, second and 10. He hands off to Littleton straight ahead. Littleton breaks one tackle, another, and drags the whole pile out to 7 yard gain.
Oh, Walkersville moving the ball on the line of scrimmage here up the middle pretty effectively on this first series of the second half for them.
It's going to bring up third and three now. Littleton managing to break off good chunks of yardage on every carry now. Seems to be getting stronger. Gant brings him out to the line of scrimmage. 8:09 to go in the third. Walkersville up 7-0. Double wing set. Right wing goes into motion. Hand off to White. Right wing around the left end. He's got first down yardage and more. 10-yard carry by that Walkersville back.
Jake Wetzel, the sophomore, 5'10", 185-pounder, found himself a lane off that left tackle. Moved past that first down marker and then some. Ball spotted inside the 30, inside the 40,
38-yard line.
38-yard line. They're going to finally settle on it.
So Walkersville penetrates into Cavaliers territory now, first and 10. Double wing set again. This time the left wing in motion. Hand off to the deep back, and he's slammed in the backfield for a 1 yard loss. Straight ahead, Plummer was there.
Yeah, Plummer just burst through that line and stopped Ty Littleton for a 2 yard loss. That's going to bring up.
Loss of three on the play brings up second and 13.
Yeah, second and 13 now.
That's not 13. That's
12.
Second and 12, yeah.
All right, we'll call it 12.
Ball spotted right on the 40 yard line now. Gant brings him out slowly. Down under center. Got some motion. Rolling to his right. He wants to pass.
He's got a man open.
Got a man wide open up the middle. And it's dropped. Oh, it hit him in the chest and bounced out. But they're looking for the flag. He wants the interference call, but he's not going to get it. Number 22 on the incompletion. And that's going to bring up third and 12.
Yeah, coverage was able to close in on him as that ball was thrown just slightly short. He had to slow down for it. Down at about the 5 yard line.
And that gave the coverage a chance to catch up. If he leads him a little bit, it's got six written all over it. Here we go. Big down for these Lions right here on their own 40. They're facing a third and 12 now with Gant under center. Again, they want to pass. Roll out to his right. Draw play up the middle. He's caught at the line of scrimmage, breaks a tackle, and lunges ahead for a 6 yard gain. But it's not enough for a first down. It's going to bring up, we're going to call it fourth and 7.
I like that play. I mean, you know, Cavaliers are able to get a mitt on him and slow him up with enough time for the linebacker to catch up to him. But they would have been fooled if he'd have gone through that cleanly.
Yeah, that saved the first down, that mitt that got on him. Okay, they're going for it with 4th and 7 now. The ball's on the 35, and the crowd's on their feet. Double wing set, right wing in motion. Hand off to the right wing around the left end. He's got his running room still on his feet. First down yard is it all the way down to the 15-yard line. The Lions convert on that one in a most impressive way.
I tell you, Jake Wetzel on the carry just was a man with a mission. He's slow to get up. May even be just a little bit winded. He's had a lot of responsibility here on this drive, but boy, he was just determined to hit that hole and hit it. He did for a big gainer. Fresh set of downs for Walkersville. Ball is going to be at the 15 now. And this has been up to this point where both these teams have struggled.
Yep, the red zone has been the issue tonight. Let's see what happens as that Cavaliers defense stiffens. I formation behind Gant. Hand off to the deep back straight ahead. Follows his blockers. Spins, drags, turns. They try to rip the ball out, but they never bring him down. But his forward progress is going to get him all the way down to the 11-yard line.
You know, Chad Gleason with the carry. Chad's a 5'8", 170-pounder. And the two defenders on him were both towering over him. And he was still able to stand on his feet. And you see where they had him wrapped up, both of them. And this has been what I've noticed on this defense by the Cavaliers in the second half is when they get to that second level of linebackers, they're trying to arm tackle up around the shoulders.
Power eye formation. Some motion movement up front. Let's see what happens. He's going to get caught in the backfield and dropped for a loss. No hankies on the play. I saw a little bit of jump there, but...
Yeah, referees have not been making themselves the issue in this game. As we've seen what apparently were infractions go uncalled on a number of occasions here tonight. 3rd down and 8.
Wetzel averaging almost 11 yards a carry now in this game. Brings him out to the line of scrimmage, 3rd and 8. The ball on the 14. Motion from the deep back, rolling to his right. He wants to pass, got some pressure. He scrambles outside, pulls the ball down. He's going to run for the marker, and he gets caught and dragged down from behind. No gain on the play. Matter of fact, he lost a couple. So the defensive front for the Cavaliers stiffens and holds, and that's going to bring up 4th and 11 now. With the ball now back on the 16-yard line.
And once again, the defense stiffens in the red zone.
And I believe we're going to see the field goal unit come on the field here. It does look that way. Number 10 is the holder. He's going to spot it on the 23, so that's going to be a 33-yard kick. Number 35 ready for the kick. He's right-footed kicker. The snap, the set, the kick is up. It's got enough leg in it. It looks pretty good. And it is good. So the Walkersville Lions tack 3 on the board to make this a 2-score game.
That's a big, big score for Walkersville right there. Beautiful. Just split the uprights on a beautiful 35-yard field goal that he just drilled.
The official mark is 38 yards on that field goal. He puts 3 on the board and extends the Walkersville lead to 10-0 with 3:49 to go in the third. So the Walkersville drive stalls on a great defensive effort by the Cavaliers, but the Lions, not to be denied, allow a come away with some points on the board, and they will now kick off to the Cavaliers, and the Cavaliers with an opportunity now to get something going here. Have their receiving unit out on the field. Number 5 back deep to receive, standing on his own 15-yard line.
Big momentum boost, shutting down the Cavaliers for the Lions on their first possession, and then turning around and coming back and getting that field goal to extend their lead to 10. 10-0 now. Third quarter, 3:49 to go.
Here comes the kick. Squib kick up the middle, takes a hippity hop, picked up at the 30, out to the 35, around the side, breaks the edge, 40, 45, 50, still on his feet and driven out of bounds at the 44-yard line. Whoa, he tippy-toed down the line and got another 10, George. Did you see that?
Ball's going to be all the way down to the 40. What a return of kick. And that is a big momentum shot in the arm.
Huge play for the Cavaliers as he just tightrope walked down that right sideline.
Ball returned by Henry Cook, 6'4", 210-pounder.
They're going to mark him out at the 48, so he must have stepped out of that line there. So it's 48-yard line in Walkersville territory, first and 10 for the Cavaliers. For the first time in the game, Lynn goes under center, and he hands off on the counter play for about a two-yard gain.
Second and 8. And Coach Steve Louette's got to have in mind what was working for him in that first half. That screen to Baca out in the right flats was a big play for them.
The middle screen?
Yeah, and that crossing route to the same spot. So if they can get enough protection and stop that Walkersville blitz on those quicker passes for, 10, 12 yards.
Spread formation. Lynn is in the gun now. He's ready. Hand off to the back. He fakes it, pulls down. Keeper got some running room. Breaks one tackle. Takes a leg, and then he's dragged down from behind. But not until he gets a first down and runs it all the way down to the 35-yard line.
Great stop by Jake Wetzel playing safety and coming up and making a play on A.J. Lynn, or he might have sprung that one all the way. So,
well, he showed his athleticism on that play because he took a leg away from that guy and got another 10 yards on that.
Wetzel's played a great game on both sides of the ball tonight.
All right, Lynn, pistol formation, two halfbacks on each hip pocket. He's ready. Hands off to the left back, off right tackle.
Got a big
secondary. He's got one man to beat, and he drags him down at the 20-yard line.
Wetzel on the stop once again, preventing another touchdown.
Right open with
field
the carry.
Tackle on the big back. Ball at the 20. First down.
So we're down in the red zone now, which has been a little problematic for these Cavaliers. Let's see if they can settle down. Coming out with a pistol again. Lynn talking to his halfbacks, ready to go. They have a little discussion there in the backfield. Now they're ready. Hand off to Baca, off right tackle. Nothing there this time. It shuts down fast. Not much of a hole.
Tackle by a host of Lions.
Great tackling defense by Walkersville throughout this game, but
no gain on the play.
We're down to 2 minutes to go now in this third.
Both teams have struggled, as we've said repeatedly, down in this red zone.
The ball's on the 20-yard line where the Cavaliers have a second and 10. They're going to stick with that same formation in that pistol. Baca on the left pocket. Straight drop, wants to pass, looking left, got a rush, middle screen, is knocked down. Beautiful defensive play by number 2, as he got a big arm up in there and batted that ball down. Otherwise, that was that middle screen we were talking about a moment ago.
Yeah, and it looked like A.J. Lynn mistook Baca, or Plummer, for Baca. The big tackle who was out there to block on that screen, as he had a host of Lions in his face.
Huge down here now for the Cavaliers with a 3rd and 10. Obviously, 2-down territory, but this is really big right here. 4 receivers split wide. Rolling to his right. He wants to pass. Lynn trying to get around the edge. Stops. Got some pressure. He turns back the other way. Reverses field. He's got some running room. He runs in. Breaks a tackle and straight ahead all the way down to the 10-yard line. 10 yards, and it was A.J. Lynn alone. All A.J. Lynn on that one.
Well, that's going to depend on the spot there, Mike.
Tackle by Christian Policelli.
That's a big 3rd down play. Sophomore Policelli brought him down, and he got the first down.
He got the first down. You see, the ball is just inside the 10 by about the length of the football, so it is 1st and goal now for the Cavaliers on a brilliant run by A.J. Lynn as he reverses field, comes back here to the near side, and gets the first down yardage.
Huge 3rd down conversion keeps this drive going for the Cavaliers. We're down to 1:10 to go here in this third quarter. Cavaliers now threatening.
Pistol formation. Lynn hands off to the back. Pulls it down. Runs with it on the quarterback option, the read option. Straight ahead for about 2 yards on the carry.
2nd and goal from the 8.
Clock running down to 45 seconds to go in the third now. Walkersville leading 10-0 with the Cavaliers threatening. Lynn brings him out. Straight drop, handoff to Bakke. He's trying to get around the right end. Got some running room. One man to beat, and he runs him out of bounds. He dives into the end zone.
Arms in the air. Touchdown. No signal yet by the ref.
No signal by the ref. All the players are signaling, but nothing by the ref yet.
Stephen Bakke with the carry.
He is down. He stepped out of bounds on the far side of the field. So
well, he was trying to beat the defender,
right,
chasing him to the edge. And as he turned, he just stepped out of bounds at the 5-yard line, or otherwise it would have been a touchdown. That's going to bring up third and goal from the 5. Actually, they've got that ball spotted a lot closer, Mike.
Yeah, it's like the 1.
Yeah, okay.
It's like the 1-yard line I'm looking at with the binoculars on the far side of the field.
Yeah, it's way over on the opposite side from our vantage point.
Lynn under center, turns and hands off to the halfback off left tackle.
He's in.
Touchdown, Cavaliers!
Touchdown!
Straight off left tackle, that dive play just went ahead on the trap.
Outstanding drive, kept alive by the great play of A.J. Lynn on that critical 3rd and 10.
So now,
finally, the Cavaliers get some points up on the board.
So now, if you're Louette, how come you don't go for the two-point conversion here?
Well, you want to keep it within a one-score field goal to tie in a regional this early on.
All right. Here comes the PAT. There's the snap, the set. The kick is up way high up in the air. And it is good.
Yeah, he did get it. Kind of trailed off to the left, but he made it through.
So we got us a ball game.
Kyle Gavin.
As the Cavaliers get on the board for the first time in this game.
6 foot, 250-pound kicker. Kyle Gavin brings the Cavaliers to within 3 of the Lions, 10-7 now. 11 and a half seconds left to tick away here in this third quarter of action. And both these teams have come out to play ball the second half and have looked impressive from the beginning. As the score reflects here in this tight contest in this regional playoff game in the 2A West.
So now the Cavaliers will tee it up on the 40 and kick off right to left on your radio dial to the Lions, and they'll receive. Two receivers down in the deep, standing on their own 20.
Jason Snell out to take the kick for the Cavaliers.
Ball is teed up and we're ready to go. 11 seconds to go in the third quarter. We'll have enough time for just a return before we go to the fourth. There's a kick. Squib kick. Onside kick. Walkersville falls on it. The ball's loose. There's a pileup. Everybody's ripping and tugging and piling. They start to unsort them now. Let's see who's got it.
Walkersville should have it. They had two guys falling it. But I tell you, it was an excellent effort by the
great
kicker.
Great onside kick by the Cavaliers.
Yeah, it's just about perfect.
And great Walkersville play as he fell on it. And he went into the fetal position and cradled it.
Well, you know, when you do something like that and you're not successful, as the odds are likely that you won't be, you're going to give the other team great field position and put a lot of pressure on your defense.
And that's what the Lions have now, 1st and 10. They hand off to the deep back straight ahead, still on his feet, running, churning, driving, 5-yard carry for Littleton.
Chad Gleason on the carry. Chunks out a big 6-yard gainer.
And that's it. That's the end of the third quarter. We've got us a great game here at South Carroll High School. The Walkersville Lions 10 and the South Carroll Cavaliers 7. We'll step aside for our commercial break and we'll be right back after this message for the start of the fourth period. 12 minutes to go, ladies and gentlemen. This is a great one.
Thermont Eye Care is passionate about providing for all of your vision needs with a caring attitude and a dedicated commitment to serving those who want the best. Located at number 2 East Main Street in downtown Thermont. Walk in or call area code 301-271-0554 for an appointment today.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. There's 12 minutes on the clock, and that is the amount of time separating from one of these teams from moving on to the state semifinals next week. Winner to be determined, but we got to sort this one out first. 10-7 is the score here. Walkersville on top, and they have the ball. Hand off to the deep back off right tackle, straight ahead. He drives, pile drives into the line and falls ahead for first down yardage and more.
Yeah, great job by that front offensive line to open up that hole. And I believe that may have been Wetzel. Can't quite make out the number. Yeah, it was Jake Wetzel on the carry and just blew through for a first down. It's going to be first and 10. Ball now spotted at the 40-yard line of the Cavaliers.
I formation behind Gant. Hand off to the deep back straight ahead. He stutter steps, jukes, and falls ahead for about three.
Yeah, Gleason able to, with some fancy footwork, make a little bit of something out of nothing off that left-hand side. We'll give him two.
Yeah, to give him two on the spot. Second down and 8 now. In Cavaliers territory, the ball is on the 40-yard line. Make it, check that, the 38-yard line of the Cavaliers. Gant brings him out. Double wing formation. Left wing goes into motion. Hand off to left wing off right tackle. He bounces off one blocker. Still on his feet. Breaks a tackle. He can go all the way. Touchdown, Walkersville Lions. What a run.
Jake Wetzel, number 22, is playing lights out football. He has been dominant in critical situations, both offense and defense. That young man has stepped up to play tonight.
And just that fast, the Lions come back and tack another 6 on the board. And they're going to tee it up and try to make it, take it back to a 10-point lead. Right-footed kicker is ready to snap the set. The kick is up. It's a low kick. It gets over the crossbar, and it is good. And we have a 17-7 game with Walkersville on top and 11 minutes to go in this game, ladies and gentlemen. That'll give us a chance to take another break. We'll be right back after this important commercial message.
Save without settling on the latest Verizon tablets at the Wireless Center, your local Verizon premium wireless retailer. Right now, get $100 off the Ellipsis 8 tablet with free after mail-in rebate. Join Verizon, the largest, most reliable 4G LTE network. Visit the Wireless Center today at 1511 Ridgeside Road in Mount Airy.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. A stunning development. South Carroll had scored for the first time in the game. Momentum had swiftly changed over to South Carroll's side. They tried an onside kick, which was unsuccessful, giving the Lions great field possession. They drove it right down the field and scored in lightning-like fashion to take another 10-point lead.
Yeah, Jake Wetzel, the running back on the big gainer for the touchdown. He's got 92 yards on 6 carries and a touchdown.
There's a short kickoff taken at the 35, still on his feet out to the 40, and drilled down at the 44-yard line as he's spun around and tackled by the kickoff team. It'll be first and 10, Cavaliers ball on their own 44-yard line.
Walkersville content to just, kick kind of a half-soft sort of dribbler down the middle.
Not sure why. I don't know why teams do that. I mean,
the Cavaliers, a great field position here.
Yeah.
As a result of that, and looking to get back in this game. Plenty of time still. 11 minutes to go. 17-7.
Gant brings him out. He has 4 receivers split out wide, 2 on each side of the field. He sends a left slot in motion. Hand off to the left slot. Reverse. Coming back the other way. He's in the secondary. Got some running room. Still on his feet. Down to the 20. 25. Breaks another tackle and run out of bounds on the far side of the field. Ladies and gentlemen, that is a 45-yard scamper all the way down to the 23-yard line. That'll break the back of that momentum.
Yeah, and I'll tell you, Walkersville's over-pursuit cost him on that one. Is that speedster wide receiver took that reverse around the left-hand side, and he was flying.
He was fast. They did a They ran that slot across the motion, handed off to him, and he did a reverse to the wide receiver. And now we've got it again, and now we've got a whistle.
So if we're going to have an
official timeout on the field. No, Walkersville calls timeout on the field. I'd like to thank our second half of this game, the sponsors here, for making this game possible. Animal Care Clinic of Walkersville and Dr. Macenas, Anytime Fitness, Asia Number One Restaurant, Brownies Auto Care, David Salon. I got my hair cut over there. How's it look?
It looks great, Mike.
Looks pretty good. Okay. All right. got a great haircut over at Davis. Gettysburg Auto Auction, Mount Airy Mattress, Salon Allure, the historic Shamrock Restaurant, and finally, Walkersville Eye Care, located in the Discovery Shopping Center, Dr. Sklar Hub and Allergy Air. Thanks for sponsoring tonight's 2A West regional title game, and it's a good one.
Our whole family are Walkersville Eye Care clients.
Excellent.
Yeah, they are outstanding there. Super nice, too.
I could say. I talked to them on the phone today, and we had a great conversation.
Yeah.
Here we go. First and 10. South Carroll has it. Quick out to the right. Wide receiver screen. Got some blockers in front. Drills it ahead for about a five-yard gain. That'll take it all the way down to 20, where it'll be second and 5 for the Cavaliers.
Yeah, just a quick out to Patrick Kelly, number 5 from A.J. Lynn, the quarterback. And Walkersville was on that one pretty good.
Yeah, the markers are short, though. It's a gain of 4, right, because the markers are yards short. So they've got 3 receivers split out to the left, 1 to the near. They get the play signal in from the sideline, no huddle, and they go to the line of scrimmage. Low snap. He puts it. Quick slant. Caught all the way down to the 8-yard line.
Enough for a first down.
Number 4 on the slant. That was just a quick hitter slant, and it worked.
Silas Kelly did a great job to pull in that dart.
Lynn hit him right. I mean, Lynn just got that ball out of his hands as soon as he received the snap.
Just a pop pass, they call it, a little inside slant.
First and 10 from the 8. First and goal, I should say, from the 8. South Carroll threatening. Hand off to Baca's faked. He rolls around the left looking for a man out of the end zone. Got a man too far out of bounds. It's incomplete. Oh, touchdown. He got his feet down. Unbelievable. What a catch. He got his feet down on that, George.
Did a great job of hauling in that ball. And I tell you, Lynn, rolling to his left, made an outstanding pass as he had some backside pressure, but this time was able to set his feet and get that ball to only where that receiver could catch it. Who came down with it?
He set a fade in the
fashion.
Yeah, set a fade in the corner. I didn't think he caught it.
Well, that's going to keep them right back in this ball game. Waiting on the point after.
The snap, the set, the kick is up, and the kick is good, and we're back to a 3-point game.
Good job by the Cavaliers.
17-14, Walkersville on top with 9:47 to go in this game. It's anybody's game for the taking.
Now you see why both of these teams are in this game tonight.
You do. Nobody's giving up here, no quitting anybody. And that was 2 lightning quick scores from both teams.
Great high school football in the state of Maryland. As we drop down to near freezing temperatures at about 35 degrees outside.
Perfect night for football. That's the way you want it. You want to be able to see your breath when you play.
You know, if I'm going to communicate one thing on defense from the coaching staff to these Cavaliers, it's tackling. You got to stop tackling the shoulders. You know, that's where Walkersville's been able to move this ball in the second half. You know, they make that first point of contact and, you know, either blow through them or they drive them back. And you see these guys struggling, 2 or 3 of them, to get the Walkersville Lions backs down. So we'll see if they can make that adjustment as the kicker's ready.
Here we go. No onside this time. He drills it all the way into the end zone for a touchback, and that'll come out to the 20. And we've got a little extracurricular activity in midfield, but it's all good.
Boy, that was an inspired special teams unit. They went down the field after that strong kick, and they just blasted the Lions receiving team. So they're clapping hands. They're all fired up. They're ready to go. Walkersville's going to have the ball at their own 20. And out they come quickly. Up to the line.
I formation behind Gant. Slot right. Hand off to the D-back. Off right tackle. And there's a flag. We had some movement on the far side. I believe that one's going to cost them 10.
Oh, we're waiting on
it's the motion is the call against Walkersville.
Okay, that'll back them up 5 yards.
So it's 5 yards, yeah. I thought it was hold, but it's motion.
That'll be first down still, but 15 to go instead of 10 now.
Ball on the 15
as the Lions restart here. 9:44 left in this contest. 17-14 visiting Walkersville, leading the hometown South Carroll Cavaliers. And this is one whale of a high school football game.
Yes, it is. Here we go. Gant, hand off to the D-back, off left tackle. He runs into a host of tacklers, tries to bounce it outside, but there's nothing there. The defense shuts it down right away.
Yeah, they shut down that gap designed for him to go through. He saw it was clogged shut, tried to go lateral to his left and get around the edge, but he couldn't do it before he was brought down. Ball, no gain, will be second and 15 from the 15.
Walkersville breaks out of the huddle. Down to 9:07 to go in this game. Gant under center. Hand off to the deep back. It's fake.
He's got a man
wide open deep. It's caught at the 40, 45, 50, and dragged down at the 47-yard line.
All the way down to the 40 went Wetzel. But Jake Wetzel just blew through that secondary and got himself wide open. That Lions offensive line gave Billy Gant plenty of time to release it, and he just threw a strike 35, 40 yards downfield.
Hard to miss it. He was wide open.
Big, huge play by the Lions here. Stuck deep in their own territory, and now have practically reversed the field.
It's a 50-yard play. I formation, hand off to the D-back, straight ahead, sticks his nose in there, nothing there, and he's dragged down to the line of scrimmage for no gain.
Looks like Chad Gleason on the carry.
So you notice Littleton's not in the backfield right now. Remember he came off limping earlier?
Looks like... Yeah, he just came back in, Mike.
All right. And they've got the play coming in the huddle now. Play clock down to 15 seconds. 17-14, Walkersville on top with 8 minutes to go in this game. Gant brings them out. Wing right, I formation. Hand off to the deep back, Littleton straight ahead. He runs hard. Good north-south running as he gets about 4 on the carry. That'll bring up 3rd and 6.
That's the way to go down low on the tackle by that middle linebacker. He just nailed Littleton, and he went straight down. He had a full head of steam but was stopped abruptly after about a 5-yard gain. We're going to call it 3rd down and 5 from the 35.
Littleton comes out now to the sidelines, and they shuttle the play in. Again, Gant, wing right, I formation. Pitch to the deep back. Quarterback option, he's going to throw it up in the air. Intercepted! Intercepted by the Cavaliers as he leaps, number 4 leaps up in the air and takes it away. And the Cavaliers shut down that threat by the Walkersville Lions on a halfback option play.
Had him beat just a little bit out of the range of the arm of Chad Gleason. As he released the ball from about the 40-yard line, got it down to about the 5, but his receiver had to hold up, which gave time for the Cavaliers to get back into coverage and step in front of that ball and bring it down. Huge defensive play with 7:09 to go in this contest, down by 3, and the Lions threatened to score. The Cavaliers come up with a big, big defensive play.
90 yards to go for these Cavaliers. Plenty of time on the clock, 7:09. They come out. Lynn under center this time. time turns, hands off to Baca. He's got some running room around the outside, and it's immediately shut down, but not until he gets 6 yards on the carry.
Great job defending there by Ethan High from Walkersville to bring the big back down for not a big gain, a good gain, but not a big gain. Could have been much more than that as he had only one other guy to beat and he got past him.
Second and four, the ball is on the 16. Cavaliers break the huddle out to the line of scrimmage now. Wing left, pistol formation, two receivers split wide. Hand off to Baca around the left side. He's got some running room. Bounces it outside. Dragged down right at the first down marker. I believe he got first down yards just on forward progress as they move the chains.
South Carolina Cavalier, first down!
Well, that gets them a little bit of comfort behind them there. Instead of having their backs stuck up to the goal line, they've got some room here to maneuver. Say the ball spotted about the 22-yard line.
So it's first and 10 from the 22. Lynn goes back to the pistol. Hand off around the left end, trying to get some running room. Breaks a tackle. Still on his feet, run out of bounds after a 12-yard gain.
And another South Carolina Cavalier, first down.
Stopped by Jake Wetzel. He would have been scampering down that sideline still. Plenty for a first down, however, as they move the chains again, and they've got the ball at the 33-yard line, I believe.
Fresh set of downs for the Cavaliers. They've got the play signaled in. They break huddle. Again with the pistol formation. Lynn takes his time, looks over the defense. Hands off to Baca. He breaks one tackle, still on his feet. Threw into the secondary.
Oh.
Breaks another. He could go all the way. One man to beat. And he's tackled, shoestring tackle at the 15-yard line. And he drops out of bounds at the 10.
Wetzel saves a sure touchdown. As they had the blitz on, got an arm on his ankle in the backfield, but the big back just kicked it free, shot through the hole, sprinted left down the sideline. It was a foot race. Wetzel was able to catch him, but not before he brings the ball all the way down to the 10-yard line. He was trucking.
Coaches out on the field. The Cavalier coaches are yelling at their players, a little confusion about the play that's being sent in as they come to the sidelines. Play clock down to 13 now. They still haven't gone to the line of scrimmage. They got the signal and they're ready. 7 seconds on the play clock. Lynn down under center. Picks to the deep back. He's got a man after him. He gets by him and caught in the backfield and dropped for a 2-yard loss.
Nice job sending that blitz of Bruce Yanga.
Loss of 5 on the play. Brings up
loses 5 yards on the play. Cavaliers rushed that play. Didn't want to burn a timeout, but it cost them 5 yards.
The ball's on the 13 now, where it'll be 2nd and 12 from the 13.
Field goal territory to tie this game if this drive stalls.
Yep, that's what we're wondering about. And there's a timeout on the field.
They're going to talk it over.
Yeah, you can't blame them. Official timeout. We've got an injured Walkersville player on the far side. He sat down, and the official called timeout. And now the subbed out as he takes his helmet off and walks to the sidelines. Crowd doesn't like it. They think that was a kind of a stall call, you know?
Well,
all right, here we go. Time in. They wind the clock.
Quarterback Lynn on the sideline talking to the coaches.
Lynn has got the play firsthand from his coach, and he runs into the huddle quickly. They huddle up, the entire team this time for the huddle. Now they break, come out. Again, Lynn will be under center, one back, Baca behind him. Motion from the right wing. The handoff to Baca off left tackle. Huge gaping hole. He vaults over one player and he's dragged down at the 8-yard line.
Well, it's 3rd and goal from the 8.
third and goal from the 8. I thought he could still get a first down. Did I see that there is no marker? No, yeah, so it is third and goal.
Yeah, that loss of 5 brought him back outside the 10.
Yeah. The scoreboard was wrong. I was going by what the scoreboard said, but it said third and 12, but it wasn't. It was third and goal. So here we go. This time, empty backfield, shotgun, right wing in motion, wants to roll to his right and pass, got some pressure, scrambles around the one by, breaks another tackle, still on his feet, slam, driven down at the 5-yard line, gain of 2 on the carry by Lynn as he makes a little something out of nothing. Well, that'll preserve the field goal anyway.
Comes the kicker.
Big, huge field goal right here. 17-14, Walkersville up by 3. Cavaliers with a chance to tie it at 3:35 to go.
Well, senior Kyle Gavin has got a big leg, and he's got a short kick.
Well, they've already blocked one of his kicks today. So here we go. Straight away, kicker Gavin is ready. There's a snap, the set, the kick is up. He hooked it left, no good. He missed the field goal. He hooked it. And the Walkersville fans erupt.
Well, 3:16 to go. Cavaliers down by 3. They're going to have to come up with another big play and be able to stop on a 3-and-out this tough rushing Lions offense. And that is a big, big, big job.
That is a task. Because now all the Lions have to do is get a couple of first downs, and they can ice this one. All bunched in tight. Wing right, eye formation. Gant, hands off to the deep back, off right tackle. Falls straight ahead, gain of about 4 on the carry. Give him 5 on the forward progress. That'll bring up 2nd and 5.
We've got timeout here.
Chad Gleason on the carry, and the Cavaliers call timeout. That'll give us a chance to get in a quick break. We'll be right back after this important commercial message.
Serving our community for over 50 years with quality service at a fair price, Brownies Auto Repair employs only ASE-certified technicians. Brownies is one of only 33 shops in the state of Maryland designated as an ASE Blue Seal of Excellence repair facility. They want to help you maintain your vehicle in a manner that keeps it trouble-free and fun to drive. Stop by today. That's Brownies Auto Repair, located on Frederick Street in Walkersville, a proud sponsor of Walkersville High School Athletics.
Yes, they are a proud sponsor of Walkersville High School Athletics. Brownies Auto Care, right there in downtown Walkersville. Check them out, the best mechanics in the area. They will help you get your car ready for winter the right way. Here we go. Both teams are out on the field. 2nd and 5 for the Lions. With the ball on the 25-yard line, Gant leans down under center. Hand off to the deep back, off left tackle, first down yardage and more as he dives ahead for a 7-yard gain.
Just a great kick-out block, giving Gleason room to cut back inside off tackle and get that first down.
Down to 3 minutes now on the clock as they move the chains. They wind the clock. And South Carroll is sitting here watching valuable, precious seconds tick away on their season, needing a stop badly.
Well, you know, if you're the defense, that all you're going to see is running. So they're bringing everybody up to the line. They're filling that box, trying to stop this. But
3 yards.
3 yards.
Straight ahead, eye formation running. We've got a player down. No, he gets up. He just was piled up on. Gleason gets up.
Got another timeout here, so one more and they're done.
One and done. If you just joined us, we thought we had a tie game with a short field goal. With Walkersville up 17-14, the Cavaliers kicker hooks it and misses the field goal. And the score remains at 17-14. Walkersville with a slim 3-point lead here with 2:34 to go in this 2A West title game. This could be, if this score stands and Walkersville can hang on, this could be the first time since 1992 that the Lions have advanced beyond the title into the state semifinals. Here we go. Gant brings him up to the line of scrimmage. Wing right, eye formation. Hand off to the deep back, straight ahead. He runs into a pack, and he gets 2 or 3 yards on the carry. It's going to bring up 3rd and 4.
Jack Gleason with the carry.
Gleason again up the middle, protecting the ball, just chunking out 2 or 3 yards. A final timeout taken by the Cavaliers.
That's their last one.
2:28 to go in this contest.
The Cavaliers need a big stop here, George. You just pinch. What do you do? Put all 12 in the box and pinch in and just blitz the gaps?
Well, you know, Walkersville in two plays is probably going to be able to get, you know,
in two plays, 45. You mean they wouldn't go for it on fourth down? Is that what you're saying? Not with 2:28 to go. All right.
Well, this is going to be the determining.
Not on this, not in their own territory with 2:28 to go. Yep. All right, here we go. Let's see. Pure speculation at this point on our parts. Wing right. No, double wing set. Gant under center. Left wing into motion. Hand off to the left wing around the right side. Shut down his line of scrimmage. No gain. He might have lost a half a yard. So that's going to bring up the decision we just talked about.
Yeah, well, Walkersville's going to punt it away, but that clock is still ticking. Down to 2:15 and counting.
And so do you take the delay of game here? Run it down, take the delay, and then punt it away?
Yeah, I mean, you may as well. Well, they haven't even started the game clock yet.
It's down to 2 minutes.
Play clock, yeah.
Everybody's, the crowd's yelling at the score.
Going to have
the
play
clock has not started.
Here.
Now it's running down to 20.
Somebody's keeping track of the time, but
yeah, it is on the field there. Game clock down to 1:40 to go. Walkersville up 17-14. And there's a timeout.
Well,
Walkersville, as they call the timeout, to preserve the delay and to bring the punting unit out on the field. The Cavaliers are going to get the ball back with about 1:30 to go.
When there's a miscommunication, you know, the officials are keeping the time on the field, and they're informing the coach who's, you know, going to be calling a timeout, how many seconds he's got left, and that's what they did. So we've got it fixed on the scoreboard. Walkersville is going to kick it away from their own 40, and they're going to give the Cavaliers one last shot here with about 1.5 minutes to play in this game.
Well, the kicker's going to be standing on about the 30, call it the 27, the punter. So he's going to be punting. This has got to be the punt of his life. And, of course, this has got to be the return of the Cavaliers' career.
Cavaliers are going to put two men deep to return.
They have two receivers back on their own 28. And we're ready.
Short kick.
Short kick. Bounces out of bounds on the far side of the field. Not returnable. And they did that one on purpose, George. I hate those short kicks. I'm not a fan of a short field for kickers. So now the Cavaliers are going to get the ball with plenty of time left. They got 1:32 on the clock. The ball is on the...
problem is they don't have any timeouts.
Yeah, that's a good point. The ball's on the 37-yard line in Cavaliers territory. No timeouts. They're going to go spread offense.
You know, you're going to have your prevent defense up
here. Pistol formation. Walkersville drops deep, too deep, rolling to his right. He wants to pass, throwing it, winging it up long. It's going to be intercepted, and it is. Walkersville intercepts it to take the game. Number 8 sits down there in center field and watches the eye of the quarterback.
I'll tell you something, Mike. Cavaliers just missed out on a scoring opportunity. As that receiver had his man beat. I got that interception because the pass was not thrown deep enough, and it was well within the range, as A.J. Lynn well knows as he comes off the sideline, hanging his head a little, being consoled by his teammates. But that ball looked like it may have just, I don't know, he must have lost his grip or something, because he only chucked it out there about 20
yards. I don't think he had himself set. I don't think he was set and squared up when he threw it.
He had his man, though. So, minute 27, Walkersville's going to be able to take a knee and run.
Knee down time for the Lions, and that's exactly what they do. Clock ticks down to 220, 122 to go. Walkersville has got this one in hand.
Brings up second down.
Gant taking his time, play clock down to 19. Watching it carefully. Crowd on the far side of the field, the blue and gold, ready to erupt. Everybody up on both benches, standing on the sidelines. There's a second knee down. 46 seconds on the clock and running. Can't stop it. So the Cavaliers have a great season. See it end here at home at Parker Field in one of the best games we've seen in a long, long time, and all on a hooked field goal.
This was a championship caliber contest tonight by both these teams.
Great display of high school football tonight. There's the third knee down, and that's going to do it, ladies and gentlemen. The clock runs down 10 seconds. The crowd counts it down, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. And the Walkersville players erupt on the far side of the field. The flags are waving. The stands are up. Everybody's pouring down out to meet the team. The coaches running, the players high-fiving, chest bumps, running all over. They are really pumped.
Well, as you said, the first time in a long, long time, several decades, this Walkersville Lions program has managed to get past the regional round and into the state tournament.
Players meet and they play in a show of sportsmanship. They meet at midfield to exchange congratulations as Walkersville will advance to the next round for the Maryland MPSSAA state semifinals, and it'll be against, let's see, George, I've got the setup over here. You got it? So South Gwynn Park is at Patuxent, Dunbar is at Patterson, and Elkton is at North Caroline. So I don't have a bracket, so you know what happens. Actually, I do know what happens. I believe they shake all this up, put it in a big pot, and on Sunday they draw out the seeds
for
the tournament, and they show the brackets on Sunday afternoon. So that's how it shakes out.
Well, it'll be interesting to see who this
see who their draw is. Yeah, yeah.
Team is going to face, but
depending on that seeding and the draw, it will decide who gets home field advantage and who has to travel. But that's the end of the season. The South Carroll Cavaliers, congratulations to them.
Outstanding.
On a great season, 10-2 for the year. They fought valiantly and hardly, but Walkersville victorious here, 17-14 out South Carroll. Congratulations to the blue and gold. They move to 10-2 on the season.
2 minutes.
So we're going to step aside for our last commercial break as we get our final game statistics for you ready. We'll be right back after this commercial message. You're listening to AM 1450, and this is your source for great high school sports. We'll be right back.
If you own a business, you know that the workday doesn't begin and end with the hours posted on your door. Hi, this is Business Development Officer Clark Briggs, and at Frederick County Bank, we understand that too. That's why we make business banking easy and accessible anytime, anywhere, from BuzzPoint's merchant reward and loyalty to online banking, remote deposit capture, to business courier service. Frederick County Bank, Frederick's true community bank, is open for business anytime, anywhere. Contact me at 301-620-1400 and online at fcbmd.com. Member FDIC.
That's the sound of the lion roar. The Walkersville Lions victorious here at South Carroll, 17-14, move on to the next round on their way with their eyes set on a chance to go for the first time ever since, 1980-something was the last state, 1987 was their last state title.
And that would have been at the University of Maryland at Byrd Field when they were playing them back then. Now, this day and age, everybody goes to Raven Stadium.
Yeah, 28 years ago, it was right around the time when Coach Paulus graduated high school from Walkersville.
Yeah. As a matter of fact, it was just a little over a year after he graduated that Walkersville won the state title.
Yeah. So hometown guy comes back to make good here.
Yeah.
And bring this Lions team an opportunity, a shot at the state championship. Mike, I've got some game stats here. And player of the game, I mean, first off, both these teams play their hearts out. I mean, a lot of individual effort out here to talk about, but with our limited time, and clearly the standout in this game for Walkersville, you know, was number 22, Jake Wetzel. Jake had 13 tackles and a sack on defense. And, it had to be three or four times from his safety position, he stopped a potential touchdown. He chased back all the way down the field on that one he broke and brought him down.
Waka, where they when missed he caught him from
goal.
Behind, yeah.
Yeah, where they missed field goal to tie the game ultimately. But on offense, just as well, I mean, he had 92 yards for a 13.8-yard average rushing, and he had 60 yards receiving. A counter for a touchdown. The other two scores, we give credit to, let's see, who was that, Mike? I'm at a loss here. Billy Gant. Let's go back to Billy Gant, the quarterback. He was 3 for 5. He had 80 yards passing. And number 5, Chad Gleason, picked up 86 yards rushing on 20 carries for a 4.3.
I want to know what Gleason's passing stats were. Was he like what... 2-0 with a pick, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. He didn't have a great day passing, no. Maybe they might want to throw that one in the circular file.
Right. Well, it was an exciting matchup. Hopefully we could reflect that in this game for you because it was one whale of a game to watch. Unfortunately, somebody had to lose here, and it was the hometown Cavaliers from South Carroll dropping this game by a field goal to the victorious Walkersville Lions, and they're going to head 30 minutes down the road to an awaiting celebration in their hometown as these Cavaliers are exchanging hugs, realizing that for a lot of these guys, it's the last time that they'll step on a football field in full gear, and they'll have their memories to preserve from here on out. It was a valiant effort, well-fought game, but clearly player of the game, Jake Wetzel for Walkersville, brought this one home for the Lions.
I agree with you wholeheartedly. When I once again thank today's game sponsors for making this broadcast possible, it is not without them that we could do this. So we thank them from the bottom of our hearts for making this possible. We hope that you will go out there and say thanks to them as well and, you know, take your business to them to show them that you appreciate what they've done. Animal Care Clinic of Walkersville and my good friend Dr. Macenas, he takes care of all of our kitties. Anytime Fitness, of course, George Approval here, the owner of that great gym over in Thurmont. Asian number one restaurant, a brand new restaurant in Walkersville, exciting Chinese fusion cooking. They've got Thai dishes, noodle soups, and much, much more. Check it out today. Brownies Auto Care, one of the best auto care clinics in the state of Maryland. David's Salon, it's a professional hair salon. They have got all full service kinds of salon treatments there for you. Gettysburg Auto Auction, great place to buy a car. Mount Airy Mattress, our friends Sue and her husband over there in Mount Airy, go over there for all of your mattress needs. Salon Allure, a great haircuttery in Walkersville, and the historic Shamrock Restaurant, home of the Green Oysters up there. Walkersville Eye Care, George's eye doctor, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Doctors Sklar, Hub, and Alger. So we want to thank all of these great sponsors for making this possible. I want to remind you that this game will be archived in its entirety, available on our website, WTHU.org, in our audio vault, and we archive it in YouTube. So all you have to do is go to YouTube and search for it, or you can go to our website and look for the link and watch the game. We've got great pictures from the game that we've taken that will be up there in the audio. You can watch it in its entirety, send it to your friends, download it for future use, keep a copy of it. It's yours at no charge.
Once again, keep an eye on our website. We'll probably know tomorrow or the next day where we're headed, and it'll be up. As soon as we know, you'll know, because you go to the website, look at our sports inbox, WTHU.org, and we will be following Walkersville to the next game. As long as they're here, we're going to be with them because we love this team and the great coaches and the great players, so we'll be there with them. George, any final thoughts?
Well, I want to give a shout-out to our stats guy. Thank you very much for covering that for us. That was a lot to track tonight.
Michael Donahue.
Mike Donahue.
Getting it done. Been here with us all season, second season in a row, Michael, huh? Yep. And he did a great job last week filling in for Tom and doing the play-by-play call in color with me, Leonor. So, okay, well, on behalf of the entire AM 1450 team, I want to thank you for tuning in. I want to thank them and just say have a great weekend. We'll be back. We're going to bring you some turkey football next Friday. That's right. Get your drumstick in your hand and get your hand on the other dial on the radio and be ready to listen to some great high school football the day after Thanksgiving next Friday. And we'll be there with you. Thanks for tuning in to AM 1450, your source for great high school sports.